In this session, we're going to look at how to convert decimals into fractions. And starting with a very simple case of a terminating decimal, like 0.24, we can immediately put the count out the number of digits, it's 2, so we just put this as 24 over 100, and then we can cancel down into lowest terms. And here we can divide top and bottom by 6 to give 6 over 25. But now we'll look at how to convert recurring decimals into fractions, and this appears in most of the GCSE syllabuses and work schemes. I'll start with a case of 0.23 recurring, that's equal to 0.23, 23, 23, 23, etc. You count up the number of digits, it's 2 in this case, and then multiply this fraction by 100 with 2 zeros. So we'll say that the fraction we're looking for is x. So 100 times x is equal to 23.23 recurring. And then we write down 1x is 0.23 recurring. And we are seeking to eliminate these last digits. So we can subtract these two equations, one from the other. And we're left with 99 lots of x on the left, because 100x minus 1x leaves 99x. And these two numbers subtracted is 23. And then we just adjust this, making 23 over 99. And that's a nice simple case. Here, a second example is where we have to cancel down to lowest terms. So we want to find 0.36. Let's say x, the fraction we're looking for, is 0.36 recurring. And again, we multiply by 100 and it gives 100x is 36.36 recurring. And then we write down 1x underneath, with the digits in line, the decimal digits in line, that is, and then subtract the two equations, we get 99x is 36. And so x is 36 over 99. And these two numbers can be divided by 9. 9 into 36 goes 4, and into 99 goes 11. So when the next example, when the number of digits increases, let's have a look at 0.321 recurring. Here we have 3 digits, so we multiply this by 1000, which has 3 zeros in it. So 1000x is equal to 321.321 recurring. Underneath, we write down 1x with the decimal digits in line, like so, and subtract, so that 999x is equal to 321. And then we just adjust this to make x the subject. And we have 321 over 999. And of course, this can be, looking at these two numbers, they are both divisible by 3, so we could say we could do that. That's 3 into that is 107, and 3 into 999 is 333. So now let's look at converting partly recurring decimals. This gets a little bit more complicated, but it's not so bad. So I'll take it as an example, 0.27 recurring, and that's equal to 0.2777, and so on. You can see this is a non-recurring digit, and this is after that we have the recurring 7. Here we go to the look at the end of the pattern, that's here, and multiply by however many places that decimal point would have to move, which is 2, so we multiply x by 100. 100 x is 27.7 recurring. We then go to the start of the pattern, that's the recurring pattern, which is here, and the decimal point would need to move one place. So we multiply x by 10. So we write down 10x is 2.7 recurring, again getting the decimal digits in line. And then we subtract 100 minus 10 is 90, so that's 90x. And subtract on this side and we get 25. And adjusting, x is 25 over 90. And again, this can be cancelled down to lowest terms because 5 goes into both. It becomes 5 over 18. A slightly bigger example, 0.2631 recurring. Here we find that the end of the, you look for the end of the pattern after this 1, and the decimal point would need to move 4 places. So we're going to have to multiply x by 10,000. 10,000x, that's got 4 zeros in it, is equal to 2631.31 recurring. And then we look at the beginning of the pattern. The beginning of the recurring pattern is here, and the decimal point would need to move 2 places. So we multiply this number by 100, so we write down 100x is equal to 26.31, again getting the decimal digits in line with each other. And then we subtract on the left, that would be 9,900x, and on the right, subtracting these two numbers, we have 31 minus 26 is 5, so it's 05. And so x is equal to 2605 over 9900, and that can be cancelled down to lowest terms as well.